fantastic week. Today, coming to you to bring you a proactive health update. So, what is going on? What is changing in the world of your immune system? So, this is the fall. This is colds, flus, and you know that other virus that's running around still causing amok. So, some updates. What do we got going on here? I really don't think that we're going to have a really bad influenza this year. Why? Most people are practicing very good hygiene. They're wearing masks. They're still distancing. They're not getting in large gatherings. So that is one factor that's going to cut this thing down quite a bit. The other thing is most people, remember, when they're in large groups, they're touching lots of things. They're indoors. And when we're indoors in the wintertime, it's cold. And remember, when it's cold, we run our heat. And what happens when we run our heat is it dehydrates our mucous membranes. When our mucous membranes are dehydrated, that makes us more susceptible for respiratory infections like the influenza, the cold, and this other virus that we have currently running around. So that's one piece, is it's important not to overly dehydrate your house. So you may need a humidifier. Now, there's the other contrast. If you don't want too much humidity in your home, because then you increase the risks of growing mold in your home, which can cause a whole nother milieu of immune suppression in yourself as well. So what's going on? What are the new things with this other virus, the coronavirus? Well, one thing we do know is we had a randomized trial come out that basically did show that N-acetylcysteine was not very effective or not very helpful in people that were getting this bug. So when I see new pieces of information like that, it tells me, well, I could scratch that off my list of preventative things or helpful supplements to be taking. Now, typically we use N-acetylcysteine as a helpful agent for the kidneys. We also use it as a mucolytic. So it still can be used to help break up mucus in the lungs. In that context, it still does help increase antioxidants, but it doesn't seem to be strong enough or very helpful in coronavirus cases. So we'll check that off the list. Definitely still big player. Lots of research continues to come out on keeping your vitamin D levels optimized. So if you haven't had that tested going into the fall, winter, really need to consider having that tested. Another thing is consider supplementing or even getting injections. Yes, we give injections of vitamin D in large amounts for people. It's quite beneficial if you don't like to take the pills or the drops. Also, if you want to load up because you might be exposed or working yourself a little harder and you want a little extra boost for yourself. So that's one thing. Now, the big thing that's going on is a second wave on its way? Is it coming? And we're seeing a lot of new cases pop up over in Europe. We're also seeing a lot of new cases pop up in the US. And here's the thing with the cases. The news is really talking about cases and tons and tons and tons of cases. And then we look at the delay of 2 to 3 weeks out and we see how many people are now being hospitalized or dying from this. And what we're seeing, if we look at the statistics, it's nowhere near what we saw earlier this year, where our immune susceptible individuals were out and about and not protecting themselves as much, elderly, comorbidities, et cetera. So most of the people that are currently getting infected are usually in that range between the age of 20 and 40, which the mortality rate for that is very, very low in that specific age group. And even the complication rate is much lower in that specific age group. You start to get above the age of 60, 65, now that complication rate goes up quite a bit. So one of the things we do know is if you're working on an anti-aging or rejuvenative strategy for your healthy lifestyle called proactive health, we know that does prevent some of the complications that can be happening with age. So the stats, if we look at the curves, we see cases going up, but then we don't see that lag time like we did earlier this year where hospitalizations are following or deaths are following that. And for me, and I don't know about you, That's the most important part. How many people are needing to be hospitalized? How many people are dying from this? And right now we're seeing that very, very low. So what I'm saying is, if you don't have comorbidities, you're generally healthy, you're proactive with your health, the likelihood of you having a really bad issue with this is very low. And most people are getting exposed to this, and then it's simply kind of going on its way. And I do believe that this may just run itself out. It just may run its course out on its own, and we may not need any interventions like vaccine or anything like that, right? So that we're watching really carefully. It could prove me wrong. I mean, in the next 3 to 4 weeks, we could be in a different situation. But right now, what we're looking at, since the start of fall, earlier this month, we're not seeing that curve step back up. So it looks pretty good. Now, again, this may be just the young, and we still have to protect some of those older individuals. But also remember, if you are one of those individuals who has issues with your health, this is the best time to invest in your health. This is the best time to invest in your health, because then we're not wondering if you're going to be hit by this thing, but we know that you'll be fortified. So if it does come through, it's likely going to cause less problems with you. You've heard me before. A lot of these long timers, these people who are having complications, I believe that they have something else going on. Either they're exposed to mold toxicity, or they might have other co-infection viruses, and this comes in and just kind of tips the iceberg and throttles them down. That's what we see a lot of in our practice, is people that get walking pneumonia, or people that get the flu, or they get other bugs, and then all of a sudden they say, ever since this one bug came through, it totally wrecked me and I haven't been able to recover. And I think what's going on is the same thing with this virus, no different than some of the other viruses, is coming along and nudging that person and then wrecking them, so we get some of these long-term issues going on. So bottom line, you got to be proactive with your health this fall. One thing we're doing, because we know proactive health is so critical, we have an interactive health strategy, which is personalized for individuals looking to benefit their health. And what we're doing now is we're even offering some great specials on some IVs. Some IV nutrients to get instantaneous nutrients in your blood system to help boost your immune system pretty quickly. So if you're interested in any of that, please do call us at 425-361-7945 or visit our website at interactivehealthclinic.com. All right, guys, if you like it, hit the like button, share this. We will see you soon with more health